Hi, this is Bob from Plugable Technologies. In a previous video, I went over managing Thunderbolt 3 devices with the Intel Thunderbolt 3 software on a Windows system. In this video, I'd like to do the same thing, but speak to a potential difference you may see when trying to do the same tasks on your own system. That sounds a little bit confusing. What do I mean by that? Well, when Thunderbolt 3 devices were first released, or rather I should say Thunderbolt 3 systems, Intel released a driver and a management utility to manage their operation on Windows. That's the Intel Thunderbolt software. So quick refresher, that software is located down here in the task tray. If I right click on it, I can do things like view attached devices, like my pluggable Thunderbolt 3 docking station. I can approve devices, change settings, and see more information about the software that's installed. Right here, we can see that the Thunderbolt software is this version. Well, if I go and look on my system manufacturer's site for Intel driver versions, I'm going to see some interesting stuff. So let's take a look. I'm going to bring over my application window. This is the download page from Intel for the drivers for my system. It's an Intel Nook desktop with Thunderbolt 3. If I scroll down in the list of available drivers, I can see a Thunderbolt 3 legacy driver for Windows 10. And then a little later, I can see a Thunderbolt 3 DCH driver for Windows 10. Now, without getting too in-depth, there's two versions, a legacy version and the newer DCH version. Now, while the drivers in essence do the same thing, the end user facing utility that's used to manage the Thunderbolt devices will look a little different. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to pause the video momentarily, stop, uninstall the legacy driver and software utility for Thunderbolt devices on my system, and install the updated Thunderbolt 3 DCH driver and utility so that we can compare and contrast how things work. All right, I've now removed the legacy version of the Thunderbolt driver for my system and installed the updated DCH version of the Thunderbolt driver from Intel. Now, when I did that, something that happened automatically is that the new Thunderbolt driver version prompted the automatic installation of a new utility to manage Thunderbolt devices. Previously, the application that you interacted with was the Thunderbolt software. Well, automatically, as a result of the new driver being installed, the system installed the Thunderbolt Control Center from the Microsoft Store. Now, this is a screenshot of the notification because that notification only stays up temporarily before it disappears. And after the Thunderbolt Control Center was installed, it gave me the option to launch it. So let's go ahead and take a look. It's actually not in the test tray, so let me search for it. The Thunderbolt Control Center. Get rid of the screenshot. And you can see it looks similar to what we've saw before with the Thunderbolt software. The similarity in the names can be confusion, but it looks somewhat different. By default, it's showing the attached Thunderbolt devices, and it shows again my pluggable Thunderbolt 3 docking station. Little bit information about it. But the way that you change what action you wish to do is now determined by clicking on this button with the three lines. They call it the open navigation menu. Some other people call it the hamburger menu because the different items look like different elements of a hamburger. So if I click it, I've got the option to approve devices, similar to what we've seen before, where I can determine what happens when these devices are connected. I can see the attached devices, which is what we saw by the default when the application started. I can manage all the approved devices on the system, from my Thunderbolt 3 docking station to another Thunderbolt 3 device I'd connected previously but isn't connected now, our Thunderbolt 3 dual display adapter. And then finally, see more information about the Thunderbolt software itself. In this instance, we can see the application version number has changed, the controller driver version has changed, and we get similar information about the Thunderbolt controller itself in terms of its NVM firmware version and the Thunderbolt security level. So, as a quick overview of everything that we've seen, initially, Intel released Thunderbolt software and a legacy driver version to manage Thunderbolt 3 devices on Windows 10. Newer systems may come with an updated DCH version of the driver that functions similarly, but its appearance in terms of its end user management has changed from the Intel Thunderbolt software to using the Intel Thunderbolt Control Center application available from the Microsoft Store. So hopefully you find that information useful, and thank you for watching.